wake up. So since we go to bed, and even during our sleep, God is watching over us. Emmanuel, the name occurs in the Bible three times. Twice in the Old Testament, that is in Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah, chapter 7 and chapter 8. And once in the New Testament, which is in Matthew 1:23. It is a Hebrew word signifying God is
with us.
And the form Emmanuel, as we speak today, appears in the Septuagint translation. That's why we get this Emmanuel from. We need to understand this. It's not just an idea. It is not a concept. It is reality. That's what God wants us to understand when he names himself the Emmanuel, God with us. And we have seen and learned as we explain God's names, the beauty of having him express himself in his name, or through his name to us, so we can get to know him a little bit. The benefit of God's presence become real when you decide to believe and to depend truly in him. You need to understand this. God promised to be with you, to be with those who believe in him and follow him. God is there for us. But to get reality to actually become real to you and me, we need to decide to believe and to depend on him. Otherwise, his desire to be with us do not come reality to you. And what is in this name, Emmanuel? Is the understanding that God is with you. You don't need to worry about whether he is with somebody else. You know he is with you. That is what matters. You see, because God is with us, we move on in life knowing that his everyday presence, because he is with us, every day we can enjoy his presence, provision, and protection. He will lead us to victory no matter what. So when we talk about God with us, we need to understand that we talk about his presence, his provision, and his protection. That is why he promised to be with us. It goes beyond to where a crucifix or an image of your Jesus with you. Of course, it goes beyond that. Because we're not relying on a cross, a symbol of a cross, or for some people even a picture of what they think Jesus looked like. No. Emmanuel is Jesus himself. And friends, and when we have him, we don't need to have anything else. What we need in our lives is Jesus Christ. And once you have him, let me repeat myself, you have everything. Because his presence with you will assure you of your relationship with him, will give you the provision and protection that you need for that day. That is why he is the Emmanuel for you and for me. Especially now when we are facing this pandemic that is turning the world upside down, and I don't need to describe it, you know what I'm talking about. Knowing that Jesus is by your side, his presence is enough for you. And that's what we're going to discuss today. So go with me, please, to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verse 20. That was Jesus speaking to his disciples. He said, go, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you to the end of the age. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
You see, Jesus knew his disciples would be threatened, concerned. They would miss his presence. It was so assuring, it was so powerful to have Jesus by their side. Especially now, when they realize that everything that Jesus said while alive became true. Now they saw Jesus resurrected, glorified. Wow. But now Jesus needs to go. And that was when Jesus told them, do not be worried. I'm paraphrasing here. Because I'm going to be with you. Always. Always. Let me overemphasize. Always. As Jesus charged them to go out and preach the gospel, which is applicable to us today, his promise to be with us also is the same. He'll be with us all the way. Isaiah 41 talked about a God that would come and would help us out. This one Bible verse here, that is Isaiah 41, verse 10. Isaiah 41, verse 10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. That is in Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. I will repeat. The Lord saying to the prophet, fear not, I am with you. Fear not, I am with you. That's so assuring. So when you look at the circumstances around you, you have a choice. You can feel fearful. You can get into all sort of moods. That's possibility. Or you can follow what God said. You can say to yourself, I will fear. I will not fear because God said he would be with me. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. The key word here is this. For I am your God. This is what you and I need to be very, very sure about. Is Jehovah your God? Have you made him the center of your life? Is really God, the God Almighty, your God? Because if he is, if you have given him your life and if you have committed yourself to him, you don't need to be afraid. You don't need to be fearful. You need to stand your ground and say, God, fight for me. And he will do it.
Amen.
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 I will uphold you with my righteous. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. He will do that. You don't need to do anything. He will do that. Your help is on the way when you trust God. Your help is on the way when you live for God. Your help is on the way when you commit yourself to God. How it's going to be, only he knows. What I need to know is I need to trust and obey and commit myself to God. Okay, the second point is his provision. And God is with you. He not just give you his presence. And his presence equals power. His presence equals security. It means you are with the Almighty God by your side. But it means also provision. And this is very important for us, especially in those days. The days we're living now. But provision is becoming a problem. Becoming a challenge. It's becoming harder. Luke 12, verse 24, Jesus again talking about this, he says, consider the ravens, for they neither sow nor reap, which have neither storehouse nor barn, and God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? It's up to you. Jesus already said, how much more value are you than the birds? So now, you are the one to decide whether you see yourself more valuable than the birds. Because if you don't trust God for your provision, that means you qualify yourself even below the birds. How God is going to do that, again, I don't know. I can share with you throughout my life how God had provided for me in a few ways. I can share my experience with you, but how he's going to work in your life is a different matter. But one thing I know for sure, if you trust him, he'll be by your side and he will provide for you. So when the situation gets tough, a situation gets really, really, really difficult, should you worry? I don't think so. Should you trust? Yes. Should you pray? Yes. Should you claim God's blessing? Yes. But worry? Why? Why are you worried? There's no need for that. And if you're worried, most likely you're not really depending on God as you should. Concern is one thing, and I've explained this to you so many times. Concern for sure. You need to be concerned, but do not let worry set in. Because once you do that, you lose control of the situation.
Yeah. Worry is a sin.
Psalm 84, verse 11 says this. For the Lord God is the sun and shield. The Lord will give you grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those who walk upright. Can it be more clear than that? He is your sun and shield, because of course in those days they need the sun to fight the battles. Whenever there was sun on the sky and they could see where they're going and where the enemy comes from or where they want to go, oh, we'd be okay. And provided they have a shield to protect their body, for those they want to protect behind them, it is okay also. That's why the language here used is, the Lord God is a sun and a shield. Now, once you understand that God is what you need, understand the promise, the Lord will give you grace and glory. It doesn't say about problems. It doesn't say about tests. It says grace and glory. So take what comes to you. Looking at the sun and the brightness and the clarity that the sun produced for you. I'm talking in spiritual terms here. And get your shield and go into battle, because the promise is grace and glory. Would you mind, please, to turn to someone and say, grace and glory comes your way.
Grace and glory comes your way. Grace and glory comes your way.
Sometimes we're so worried, eh? For those of you online, sometimes we're so worried about problems. And we forget that God has promised grace and glory. By the way, Jesus never said it will be easy. That's another lie that goes around in Christian lives. Jesus never said it will be easy. But one thing Jesus said over and over again, and we see this both in the Old and the New Testament, victory is guaranteed for those who believe in God. How that victory is applied, again, each case is a case. But I trust my God, and I have lived quite a number of years serving this God. And I can testify how precious and how wonderful he this. He has offered his presence. You don't need to search for it. You don't need to do anything in order to have God's presence with you, Jesus with you, the Holy Spirit with you. Provide you love him, provide you accept him, provide you do your best to follow him, he's there for you. His presence is there. His presence is there. The second thing is, as I mentioned, protection. Oh, protection. I should say provision now, not protection. Protection is the next one. His provision is there. His presence, his provision. So you're okay now. You have him, you have his provision. But beyond that, you need to understand that God is by your side to protect you, even when you do not know, even when you're not aware of it, even when you're not understanding what's going on. God's eyes on your life. God's eyes are on your life. And I can assure you that my life is spared so many times over. Some I did see it, some I didn't. Situations in my life that came to me that God rescued me and intervened in ways that I could ever imagine. I didn't ask for it. I didn't foresee it coming my way. God intervened because he was by my side, and one of the reasons is to exercise and provide protection. Let's go to Psalm 46. Verses 1. Verse 1 through 6, you can read that, but I'm going to read verses 1 and 2. God is our refuge and strength, and I highlight refuge and strength, our very present help in trouble. Sometimes we keep avoiding troubles, and I agree with that. But when we are in trouble, remember this, God is very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Well, that's a picture that is. Imagine earth be removed. Some of us here, I believe, have experienced being in the midst of an earthquake. I have a couple of times, minor ones. Enough to make you realize what that could be, a big one. Because we take for granted our ground, right? We take for granted where we stand. We choose where we walk, so we know we're not in a slippery ground. We try our best to be in a solid place. But suddenly you're standing and you feel yourself moving. And what's going on? Oh no. My ground is moving. And for those of you who experienced that, you know how bad it is. It is just not nice. Imagine the mountains being carried into the midst of the sea. Imagine if you see this with all the, wow, how could that be? Well, if you be in that situation, remember this. God is our refuge and strength. Not just refuge. That's why I enjoyed this passage so much, as many others. God is not providing only a refuge for you to come and be protected. He's providing a refuge for you to come, yes, but he provides also to you the ability to get stronger during the situation. He's our strength also. So next time over, guess what? You'll be stronger. And that's what most of us miss when you're in the middle of a problem, in the middle of a situation. You're so eager to get out of that, that we talk to God like, you know, please fix it all for me. Like, you know, those parents that they're so careful with the children that they isolate the children and they protect the children so much when the children goes out in the world, they know what the world is. I have seen young adults like that. They being so protected by the world, and that when they step out, they, wow, they're not prepared for the world. They're not prepared for life. Well, God doesn't want that to happen. And that's why God allowed things coming into our life. By the way, the Bible says that you will never be tempted beyond your capacity. So God is in control. Oh, it's so hard. Because there's an opportunity we have to share the good news, okay? It's not about monetizing stuff or about being popular. We don't need that. We're doing this for the gospel. With one touch of a button, you can send the link to dozens of people, even hundreds of people there, and give them a chance to watch the service, to join in the service with us, and be blessed as you are. So think about that, pray about that, and do your part, because we're doing ours as far as the leading team is concerned. Okay? Okay?
Amen.
That's right. Amen. Someone said amen. Will you say amen with me?
Amen.
Father God, I thank you for the worship. And I thank you, Lord, as we do this now here in Macau, I pray that hundreds will be able to enjoy and be blessed as we worship here. People in the Philippines, people in Brazil, people in Africa, people out in Japan and Indonesia and so many parts of the world, USA and so many other parts. Father, just pray that your Spirit reach them out as we are being blessed here as well. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please stand with me. Let us worship God.
Let me all give up. Amen.